Once you are in Blender and see your favorite cube in front of you, you must go to the scripting menu and open a new text script. Here is where we are going to write Python stuff in Blender. So first of all, import the Blender Python library. Then select the vertex mesh. And to do that, we must write blenderpythonlibrary.context.scene.objects. Then select the object that you want, in this case a cube, .data.vertices. If we want to know if everything is okay, we must print the vertex mesh on screen. So run the script, click this button up here, and nothing happened. Well, in reality, a text appears here, and it says that the script is actually running. So where is the printing? To see it, we must go to the window menu and click on the toggle system console. As you see, there is this mesh vertices collection, but we want an array. To do the transformation, let's call vertex, the variable that we want to obtain. For every element of the mesh, we must add to the vertex variable the vertex mesh.i coordinate. We know that the coordinates are 3D, so we want the x variable, the y variable, and the z variable. So now if we print the vertex, we see the coordinate of the cube. The index of the mesh is very similar to this command, but the last part is data.loops. We go in a loop that passes every element of the index mesh. Then we create a variable that is increased inside the loop, and we want that the index is formed by 3 points because every surface must be a triangle. So triangle index are formed by 3 coordinates, and obviously if n equals 3 we must restart from 0 for n, and the triangle index is equal e dot vertex index. First time we enter in the loop, we change the first element of the triangle index. The second time we change the second element, and the third time we change the third element, and the third time we upgrade the index variable. I made the mistake because we must go to the layout, go to the edit mode, and see that in this case the surfaces are formed by quotes and not triangles. We must select all the surfaces, right click, and triangulate faces. In this way, we change all the faces in triangle. Then we must return to the object mode, click object, apply all transformation. Scripting, run script. As you see, the number of indexes increase because obviously there are more triangles than quotes to complete a cube. Then if you want, we can also color the mesh. I prepare for this occasion a fox model that is colored and is very wonderful. Now, if we want to effectively save the information, we can use two different libraries. The first one is the NumPy library, and the second one is the OS library. OS is just used to change the directory of the current Blender file. Instead, NumPy is used effectively to save the data. Let's call it, for example, the BlenderInfoVertex.date. We want an array of vertices. And similarly, we can save also the other information. The Python part is even simpler. So we must create a loadPoint function that takes in input the path where the files are contained and also the name of the files. So name of file vertex and name file index. As before, we need the NumPy library and also the OS library. The OS library, as before, is used to change the directory path and then effectively load the vertices. So vertices equal np load text name file vertex, and also we load the indexes and return it.